everybody. Darren Cavanocchi here with my legal colleague and friend, Rosemary Chavez. Rosemary is in the race for the Long Beach City Prosecutor's Office. So I thought it was important, Rosemary, that if people are going to consider voting, and by the way, if you haven't registered yet, register and vote. It's not only a privilege, I think, not just a right, it's a privilege. Get out there and do it. But I want people to get to know you a little bit, Rosemary. So tell us, who's Rosemary and why should we care about you in this election?
Thank you very much. Well, I'm a Southern California native. I was born in Montebello, raised in Pico Rivera. My family lost my father when I was very young. So I was raised by a single mother in a very homogeneous Mexican-American neighborhood. I was lucky to go to Catholic schools and able to get scholarships into college. And even though I was a teenage mother, I went on and finished law school by the time I was 27. And I started working for the city of Los Angeles as a prosecutor, and I've been prosecuting misdemeanors for 26 years.
Wow. Wow. You know, it's funny that you went to Catholic school because my family is Jewish, and we like to say that, you know, Jewish folks are born feeling guilty, but Catholics have to go to school to learn it. And my daughter, of course, goes to a nice Catholic school.
So, yes, yes.
So let me ask, though, what was it that made you want to become a lawyer in the first place?
You know, when I was very young, my mother was ill, and I felt so powerless, and I was going to get put into the foster care system. And I thought that as an attorney, I would be able to help other people protect their rights and assert their rights and not feel powerless. And so that's what got me into law school. And then when I joined the city attorney's office, I realized that I could really do justice as a prosecutor by making sure that the police department and the police officers making arrests observe all the rules and respect people's rights and not just rubber stamp what they do in charging individuals who might have been found making a bad decision on a bad day.
You know, it's so interesting because I've been working as a defense attorney for nearly two decades now, and oh my God, I feel old.
not as old as me.
Well, I've often thought that you can have a greater impact on the justice system by being a fair-minded prosecutor than you can as even the most gifted defense attorney. I think with the discretion that you have as a prosecutor, with the ability to fashion an appropriate kind of an offer as a prosecutor, that there's more that you can do to help people and serve people as a prosecutor than really doing anything else in the justice system.
I so believe that. I'm so committed to the principles of the Constitution, the belief that everyone is presumed innocent. And when you're talking about misdemeanors, you're generally not talking about people who are bad actors, who are just craven-hearted, who are criminals. You're talking about usually regular folks who've made a very, very bad decision.
Right.
And you don't necessarily have to stigmatize their entire life just by charging them with a crime and forcing them into the system. There are other ways to fashion a just result and make sure
and keep people from being repeat customers in
exactly.
a system that has taken some knocks. Well, any other last thing for people to know about before we sign off?
Well, I think Long Beach could have the best prosecutor's office in the world, be just and efficient, but the voters there have to vote for me.
That's right, and it all starts with voting. So please consider voting for Rosemary. If I lived in Long Beach, you'd be getting mine. I think I may move just so I can vote for Rosemary. And if you're not registered to vote, get out there and do it.
You can do register it right online.
All right. Thanks for joining us, guys. We'll see you soon.